Hello students, let us continue the session on trigonometry. We were solving NCERT example questions. We have completed exercise 8.1 as well as exercise 8.2. Let's begin with exercise 8.3. The first question of exercise 8.3 is to prove question 1 to question 7 is of this type. We need to consider left hand side, then show that it is equal to the right hand side. Let me consider the first one, left hand side. In the left hand side, we have got sine theta upon 1 plus cos theta plus 1 plus cos theta upon sine theta. Better way is to take the LCM. If I take the LCM will be the product sine theta multiplied to 1 plus cos theta, then it becomes sine square theta plus 1 plus cos theta the whole square. So we will expand this 1 plus cos theta whole square. We'll be getting sine square theta plus 1 plus cos square theta plus 2 times of cos theta divided by sine theta multiplied to 1 plus cos theta. Here sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1 plus 1 is added, we get 2 plus 2 cos theta divided by sine theta multiplied to 1 plus cos theta. Here I'll take 2 as common, I'll get 1 plus cos theta divided by, we have sine theta multiplied to 1 plus cos theta. Observe, there is a one plus cos theta present in both numerator and denominator. 2 into reciprocal of sine theta is cosecant theta, we get 2 cosecant theta. This is nothing but the right hand side. Hence we are getting left hand side equal to right hand side. Hence we have proved it. Second question. In the second question, we need left hand side. The left hand side is tan theta, tan A upon 1 plus secant A minus tan A upon 1 minus secant A. What comes to your mind when it is given like this? The one thing is, we can take tan A as common thing in both these terms. And one more thing is, here we have 1 plus secant and 1 minus secant. On taking LCM, we'll be getting 1 minus secant square, so that I can make use of the identity 1 plus tan square theta as secant square theta. We can do something over that. So let me take tan A as a common thing. I'll be getting 1 by 1 plus secant A minus 1 by 1 minus secant A. Now I'll take the LCM, I'll get tan A multiplied to, in the denominator it becomes 1 minus secant square A, in the numerator it is 1 minus secant A minus 1 minus secant A. Here positive 1 and negative 1, they go cancelled. We'll be having tan A multiplied to, is minus 2 times of secant A divided by 1 minus secant square A. Now if I multiply minus 1 and divide by minus 1, I'm doing a small trick here, so that I can make use of the identity. So tan A minus 1 multiplied to positive will be positive, sorry, minus will be positive 2 times of secant A, and in the denominator it becomes secant square A minus 1. Secant square A minus 1 is nothing but tan square A. Therefore tan A into 2 times of secant A divided by tan square A. Here, one of the tan will get cancelled, we'll be getting 2 times of secant, which is nothing but 1 by cos A divided by sin A by cos A. Here, cos A will get cancelled. So we get 2 times of 1 by sin A, which is nothing but 2 times of cosecant A. This is our RHS. Hence we have proved, since LHS is equal to RHS, we have proved the second one also. Let's look at the third one. In the third one, we have got a statement like thing. If tan A is 3 by 4, then sin A into cos A is 12 by 25. Is this true? For doing that, let me make use of the basic definition. Tan A is 3 by 4. I can take it with some variable, say 3x by 4x. We define tan A as opposite side of angle A by adjacent side of angle A. If I consider a triangle such that this angle is considered, opposite side is 3x, adjacent side is 4x, by the common sense we can say that 5x will be the hypotenuse. So sin A into cos A is our left hand side. I'm taking the left hand side. Let me substitute the value of sin A. Sin A is opposite by hypotenuse, 3x divided by 5x, into cos A is adjacent side by hypotenuse. We get x getting cancelled, we'll be getting 12 upon 25. So this 12 upon 25 is nothing but the right hand side, hence we have proved. Question number 4. The left hand side is sin alpha plus cos alpha multiplied to tan alpha plus cot alpha. I'd like to convert everything in terms of sin and cos so that something may get cancelled. Here, sin alpha by cos alpha in the place of tan alpha, and cos alpha by sin alpha in the place of cot alpha has been done. Here I'll take the LCM. The LCM will be sin alpha multiplied to cos alpha. So on taking LCM, I'll be getting sin square alpha plus cos square alpha. We know that sin square alpha plus cos square alpha is 1. So sin alpha plus cos alpha into 1 by sin alpha into cos alpha. I can separately write this sin alpha divided by sin alpha into cos alpha plus cos alpha divided by sin alpha into cos alpha. Here sin alpha will get cancelled, cos alpha will get cancelled. We'll be getting 1 by cos alpha plus 1 by sin alpha. What is 1 by cos alpha? It is secant alpha. 1 by sin alpha is cosecant alpha. This is nothing but the right hand side. Again, we have proved, since LHS and RHS are equal, the statement is true. The next one, the left hand side here is root 3 plus 1 multiplied to 3 minus cot 30 degrees. Root 3 plus 1 multiplied to 3 minus cot of 30 degrees is a standard angle, so I can substitute the value, which is root 3. Let us multiply now. Root 3 multiplied to 3 will be 3 times root 3. Root 3 multiplied to root 3 is 3, so we get minus 3 plus 3 minus root 3. This plus 3 minus root 3 will go cancelled. We get 2 times root 3. This is our left hand side. Let me take our RHS. We have tan cube 60 degree minus 2 times of sine 60 degree. Tan cube 60 degrees. tan 60 is root 3, so root 3 cube minus 2 times of sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Let's simplify this. It will be 3 root 3 minus root 3. We get it as 2 root 3. Look at left hand side and right hand side, both are equal, hence we have proved it. Next question. 1 plus cot square alpha divided by 1 plus cosecant alpha. What can be done here? I'll take the left hand side is 1 plus cot square alpha upon 1 plus cosecant alpha. If you can remember and recall, there's an identity connecting cot and cosecant. We know that 1 plus cot square theta as cosecant square theta. So this cot square alpha can be written as cosecant square alpha minus 1 divided by 1 plus cosecant alpha. Let's make use of a square minus b square identity. We get cosecant alpha minus 1 to be multiplied to cosecant alpha plus 1 upon 1 plus cosecant alpha. Here you observe 1 plus cosecant alpha will get cancelled. What remains is 1 plus cosecant alpha minus 1. Positive and negative 1 will get cancelled. We'll be getting cosecant alpha. This is nothing but the right hand side. Therefore, left hand side and right hand side are equal to each other. Let's do the next question. Question 7. Let me take the left hand side part. It's tan theta plus tan of 90 degree minus theta. Tan theta plus, we know that tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta. Let me convert this in terms of sine and cos. Then let us take the LCM. After taking the LCM, I get sine square theta plus cos square theta divided by sine theta cos theta. This will be 1 upon sine theta multiplied to cos theta will be the product cosecant theta into secant theta. Let me take the right hand side now. In the right hand side, we have got secant theta multiplied to secant of 90 minus theta. By the complementary relation, I know secant 90 minus theta is nothing but cosecant theta. Now you see left hand side becomes equal to the right hand side, hence we have proved it. Question number 8. Find the angle of elevation of the sun when the shadow of a pole h meters high is root 3 h meters long. Let me draw a rough figure. If a right angle triangle is considered, this perpendicular I'll consider as a pole, PL pole, and the angle of elevation of sun S is theta and the pole is h meters and the shadow formed is h times root 3 meters. So I have considered height of pole to be PL, which is h, length of shadow SL, I have taken it as h times root 3. So with respect to theta, tan theta will be h by h root 3, h will get cancelled. We get tan theta as 1 upon root 3. We know that tan of 30 degree is 1 upon root 3. Therefore, the angle of elevation is 30 degrees. Question 9. If root 3 tan theta is equal to 1, find the value of sine square theta minus cos square theta. They have given that root 3 tan theta equal to 1. From this, I can write tan theta as 1 upon root 3, which is nothing but tan of 30 degrees. So theta value will become equal to 30 degrees. Now consider sine square theta minus cos square theta. This will be sine square 30 minus cos square 30. What is the value of sine square 30? It is 1 by 2 whole square minus root 3 by 2 whole square. If you simplify further, I get 1 by 4 minus 3 by 4, which is nothing but minus 2 by 4, which is minus 1 by 2. So the value obtained is negative 1 by 2. Question 10. A ladder 15 meters long just reaches the top of a vertical wall. If the ladder makes an angle of 60 degrees with the wall, find the height of the wall. If I consider a right angle triangle, let me write this as WL representing the wall. Let me take the height of the wall to be some x meters, and it is given that the ladder makes an angle 60 degrees with the wall. So this angle formed is 60 degrees, and the height of the ladder is 13 meters. Let me write this as A so that it becomes a right angle triangle AWL. Let me consider vertical wall to be WL, which is x meters. Then length of inclined ladder is 15 meters and the angle of 60 degrees is made by ladders at wall. With respect to 60 degree, what is cos of 60 degree? It is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Cos 60 degree is 1 upon 2, which is equal to x by 15. So the value of x will be 15 by 2, which is nothing but 7.5 meters. So the height of the wall is 7.5 meters. Question number 11. Simplify. 1 plus tan square theta multiplied to 1 minus sine theta multiplied to 1 plus sine theta. Observe here we have A minus B multiplied to A plus B, so I can use the identity. It becomes 1 minus sine square theta. 1 minus sine square theta is cos square theta. This will be secant square theta into cos square theta. We know that secant square is a reciprocal of cos square. So 1 by cos square multiplied to cos square, they get cancelled. We get the value as 1. Question 12. I'll consider this as the last question for today's session. We'll see the further questions in the next session. The last question for today's session: if 2 times sine square theta minus cos square theta equal to 2, find the value of theta. I'll take 2 times of sine square theta minus cos square theta equal to 2. I will make use of identity. Instead of cos square, I'll consider 1 minus sine square theta. On simplification, we get 2 times sine square theta minus 1 positive sine square theta equal to 2. further, it becomes 3 times sine square theta equal to 3. So sine square theta will be equal to 1. So sine theta value is plus or minus 1. If you consider sine theta value to be positive 1, we get theta value to be 90 degrees. What if sine theta value is negative 1? We know that it can be written as sine theta equal to minus of sine 90 degree. This can be written as minus sine theta, so minus sine of minus theta equal to minus sine 90 degree. This concept you are going to learn in higher classes. So sine of minus theta value is sine 90 degree by cancelling out the negatives. So theta value will become minus 90 degrees. So what could be the other values of theta? It can be 360 degree, minus 90 degree, 270 degree. If you consider the positive axis, there is some rule called as Ayers TC rule. A means all the trigonometric values are positive here. Yes means only the sine and the reciprocal of sine, cosecant, will be positive. Tan and cot will be positive. Cos and secant will be positive. The rest of the things are negative here. How do you remember this? This is a trick for class 11th. However, I'll tell you all students take coffee. This is how you can remember, or else there is another way. All silver teacups. Here in the first quadrant we have angle between 0 and 90 degree, all values are positive. When angle is between 90 to 180 degree, only the sine and reciprocal of sine will be positive. When it is third quadrant, angle more than 180 degree, less than 270 degree, tan and cotangent values are positive, rest are negative. In the fourth quadrant, cos and secant are positive and the rest are negative. Here, minus 90 degree is nothing but 270 degree. So 270 degree is the value of sine 270 degree, which is negative 1. Therefore, I can conclude 90 degree and 270 degree are the angles for which we get this relation true. That's all for today's session. Thank you.